Mutia is just one of many Filipinos who fell victim to a scam through a text message from an unknown number. As a load retailer, she initially believed the offer to be genuine, and it was too late when she realized that it was a scam.
May nag-text sa amin ng random text na mag-load daw ako sa kanya ng 500, tapos dadoblehin niya yung load ng 500 ko. It means magiging 1,000 siya. Eh, yun. Hindi ko akalain na ganun yung ano na scam siya. Huli ko na nalaman na scam pala yon, na dapat pala yung mismong network yung magte-text sa amin na dadoblehin yung load kung sakali.
In response to such incidents, Jason Brasileño, the strategy head of GoTime, issues a crucial reminder to the public. Verify details before transacting over the phone or online.
Make sure na bago kayo mag-send ng pera, face-to-face, na-validate niyo yung material or na-validate niyo yung bagay bago magbigay ng pera. Huwag basta-basta maniniwala sa nagpapadala ng account at name. Validate po muna natin.
The prevalence of scams, especially with the growth of technology, underscores the importance of exercising caution in digital transactions. However, it is not all bad news. Perpetrators of online crimes are being successfully caught and prosecuted. The Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center, or CICC, is at the forefront utilizing the skills of Filipinos in this field.
We use tools and expertise ng Filipino to track them down, and we are very successful in that.
Under Secretary Alexander Ramos, the CICC Executive Director emphasized the need for the people to refrain from responding to texts or calls from unknown numbers, as doing so could mark the number as active.
Don't answer to texts and calls from YouTube na hindi nyo kilala. Kasi the moment na sumagot kayo, nandun na kayo sa reserve file na pwede lang padalan every now and then. The numbers na hindi nagre-respond, tinatanggal din nila yon kasi magastos on their part.
Adding to this, Art Samaniego, spokesperson for ScamWatch Pilipinas, warned the public about the monitoring of social media as a potential threat in the fight against scams and phishing.
So ito yung warning sa mga taong gumagawa ng mga crime gamit ang social media. Matitrace at matitrace po kayo.
Despite the challenges, he reassured the public that with the collaboration of CICC and ScamWatch, solutions are being sought with the assistance of various government agencies. Jed Neresina, UNTV News and Rescue. We serve the people. We give glory to God.